Good, good, good. Now we don't have to redo the intro. Perfect.
Excellent. Okay, so, yes, last time, drunk, came down elevator, jarred cord because thrown, and now we hear, and we get to see what's in the basement of the tower.
Oh, yeah.
Didn't, 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 didn't. An ember and a guy that's slowly creeping towards me.
All right, let's see
Oh, he's
the.
fast.
Jeez. Nothing like a little warm up, right?
Yeah, a little mini boss from what it looks like to get
That is a pretty
this.
freaking cool sword, though. I wonder if you get to have it.
That would be really neat. A little ice breath. Man, I need endurance really bad.
That
Because
guy is
I
just.
have no stamina.
Yeah, he is just whipping you all around the place.
There we go. And we
Hey, I think you
did get
got
his
it.
sword.
Nice.
Let's check this beast out. Where is it? Rapier. We can actually use it right off the bat.
Oh, dude, that's awesome.
And it's actually
Is
better than
it
the sword
better?
we're using.
Nice. It weighs less too, doesn't it?
It
Or
weighs
no, it weighs
1 pound
more.
more.
That's right.
But it's better in everything else.
Gotcha.
Oh, would you look at that?
Ooh, that's sexy.
Look at those nice particle effects of the frost coming off the blade.
Yeah, and those three equal segments. But you can only
Yeah.
tell if you zoom way in. No, I don't blame the devs. I'm sure it's a lot easier on computing power if it's just in those three, it's the same thing repeated in those three
Yeah,
areas.
it's actually a really long blade too.
Do you get any different swipes with that?
That's what I'm checking out right now. There's a new
And
one. We get a little jab whenever we roll, instead of the broadsword doing like a big swipe.
now you were digging the pole arms last time, right?
I played around with them a little bit. Yeah, the halberd. I think we had old Lucy.
Yeah, but it was the spear that you liked the most.
Oh, that's right. We're actually trying to get some dexterity behind us so that we can use this boss weapon spear we got from the big tree.
Yeah.
We also have this, but it's massive, so not gonna use that anytime soon, I don't think. But yes, dexterity is what we are working towards to get that leveled up a little bit.
We fixed.
But
Alright,
for
now, for those
now,
of you guys who are just joining us for the first time, this is Drunken Dark Soul. So what
yes.
that means is that Alex here, who's playing, is going to be drinking every time he has to drink from an Estus flask. Drinks one drink, and anytime he heals, like right now, he has to take a drink as well.
Absolutely, first drink of the evening.
Yep,
That
so what are you drinking
includes
tonight there,
resting up on.
Alex?
I am actually drinking original Captain Morgan
Ooh, nice.
with a little bit of Dr. Pepper.
Ooh, so it's gonna be spicy tonight.
Yes, got a little kick to it, but first drink of the evening for healing at a bonfire. Cheers.
Cheers, everyone. Why don't you guys type in chat what you're drinking tonight? So we can know what you guys are up to.
Yes. And if anything of it sounds particularly delicious, I might acquire the means to make it next stream.
Ooh, yes. Ah, nothing's better than a good, like, tasty mixed drink.
Nope, and I will for sure let you guys know. Okay,
One of my favorite mixed drinks is, so I love Jaeger. That's my thing.
Jaeger's delicious. I.
It is. Now, it's really licoricey for
Oh
those of
my
us who have
God!
tried it. Oh,
Just
wow.
kill it! Just kill it! Just die!
Kill it with fire. Oh, you killed it with ice, though.
That thing
That's
is
cool.
so creepy. Like
Yeah.
I feel like I'm in like a paranormal movie with like things like they're like the feathered versions of the things from that one alien movie, the M. Night Shyamalan, that you like don't see the alien until the very end.
Oh, yeah. Now, are you gonna do the aerial strike?
Hoo-yah!
There we go.
Okay, continue about Jaeger.
Oh, yeah. So, any of you guys who haven't tried Jaeger yet, Jaeger can be really licoricey tasting,
Yeah.
and
That could be an
that
appeal
can
to
really,
some.
it can be an appeal to some, and it can really turn some others away. But really, what's interesting about it is that how it mixes with other drinks, and it mixes with citrus really well to the point where you almost can't taste the licorice. That's just my opinion. You guys would have to try it out on your own. But If you guys go to try it out the first time, you don't like licorice, I would try not taking a straight up shot because that's usually what turns people away.
Yeah,
it's a really strong drink.
It's an extremely strong, unique flavor, and like he said, very black licorice esque.
Yeah. Now, if you have Jaeger Spiced, which is their vanilla version, it's vanilla and I can't remember off the top of my head. Anyway, that's made to be drunk neatly. Normal Jaeger actually isn't meant to be drank by.
Fly, you fool! He did not fly.
Sorry for the late reaction there. I don't know why. Just now got your joke.
And this guy's just shooting poison at me out of his little stick.
I am with my staff, and
oh, I got a staff.
Oh, storyteller staff.
He is a storyteller.
Nice.
Wasn't telling very good stories, I wasn't entertained.
These look like really bastardized versions of the flying monkeys from Wizard of Oz.
They kinda do. They kinda do. Except I don't think the monkeys from the Wizard of Oz, like, I feel like it would have been very inappropriate for them to just have their rings rip out of their backs, like, mid-movie. Like, oh, we're just regular monkeys, until we're not.
That's true.
Okay, so it looks like this drop down here is where we need to go next.
Oh, Jaeger Spice is cinnamon and vanilla.
Yum. Yes. Yum? That actually, I've never tried Jaeger Spice before.
You haven't, you should. It's really tasty, you'd like it.
Critical foe ahead.
It's no, like, it's no Captain Morgan Cannonball. Like, it is still Jaeger.
It's hard to be Captain Morgan Cannonfire.
Captain Morgan, for those of you guys and gals who haven't tried Cannonfire, it's like, it's a really, really nice, well-made rum. Like, Jaeger Spice and, so usually when you talk about alcohol, you talk about, like, kind of what shelf they'd be on. Top shelf, medium shelf, low shelf, and in between. And the Cannonball is moderately expensive. I mean, for the amount of volume that you get, and it would be kind of closer to the top shelf. Jaeger Spice would be just maybe one shelf under that. So it is a lot more cost effective to buy Jaeger Spice.
Oh,
it's
yes.
Very tasty.
That's the only problem I have with Cannon Fire. It tastes so good, but the bottle is just not big enough.
Yeah.
But
it
definitely, it's definitely worth it for the taste, though. The taste.
What was that thing that you just picked up?
I just got a few weapons, actually. I was just waiting for you to finish our liquor talk before we spotlighted them. So I just killed a hunter. Well, no, they're not hunters in this game. They're fellow, like, undead. And I got the butcher knife.
Nice, I saw that.
Which is basically a giant meat cleaver.
Wow, but that's not as good as your current sword, right?
No, from what it looks like, I can't even use it. It only scales off of strength, and it's a very high-scaling weapon, so it's not going to be super good until I put sufficient points into strength for it.
Gotcha.
But I also picked up these, the Brigand Twin Daggers.
Ooh, now I know in the previous game, you had to get your dexterity up before you could dual wield. Is that the case in this one?
No. So they changed dual wielding in this game. You can not dual wield any weapon you please.
Oh.
So that's kind of sucks. But they have select weapon sets that are dual wieldable. So this is one of the sets. So as you can see, one-handed, just a single knife, some cuts, some stabs, all that good stuff. But if I go to two-handed like I would a usual weapon, I pull out the second dagger.
Okay.
And now I can use them in tandem.
Now, does this have a power stance as well, like the katana did?
No, the L2 for this one is like a bloodborne dash.
Oh, okay.
So I can just slide. But these are not very strong. They're more
right.
For like...
They're just fast.
They're very fast. I would assume they're good for like putting like a status effect, maybe bleed or poison on them so that you can apply it super fast.
Oh yeah, you know, that'd be good.
Are you alive? You are alive. Wake up!
Yep.
Wake up! And stop that. Just stop it. Oh. Now he's telling me to stop it.
Man, there's just a flurry of feathers.
Yes, I cannot actually see anything. And I need to drink, because he actually hurts a lot. And they were tied in a Titanite shard. Very nice.
Gotcha.
Okay.
Looks like you owe us a drink there, bud.
I do owe us a drink. Cheers.
Cheers, everybody.
So good.
Yes. So, speaking of drinking, I never got to explain what my favorite Jaeger mix is. But before I do that, a real quick, two really quick and easy Jaeger mixes that are pretty tasty are like Jaeger with cheap off-brand Mountain Dew.
Really?
Yep. Or just with Mountain Dew in general.
Okay.
And then
any lemon lime flavored soda, basically.
Basically, maybe not Sprite, but
nah. But like more the yellow style drinks, other than
yeah.
like mellow yellow style, maybe.
Right. Yeah, like mellow yellow or
Mountain Dew,
Mountain Thunder, or any of those things.
Mountain Thunder.
Yeah, from the dollar store.
Hey, some of that dollar store soda is like amazing.
Oh my goodness, if you get...
Oh, he's coming at me! That's so fucking weird!
Dollar store, like, cream soda, if you mix that with rum chata, it is, like, the best thing, as far as, like, a creamy alcohol drink I think I've ever had.
Honestly, I think some dollar store sodas are better than, like, the original sodas, but
yeah.
The one thing I've noticed about dollar store soda is they tend to go flat a lot faster than... regular, like, name brand.
I do. And do you know the trick for, like, keeping sodas from going flat whenever you're storing them?
No.
Store them upside down.
Really now?
Yeah, actually, I've got a perfect example. I've got my mini fridge right here, and I stored a 20-ounce Mountain Dew in there that I drank a little bit of.
Oh my god. Nope. I just died.
Oh no! Well... So, for those guys joining in, that means Alex owes us a straight-up shot.
Those guys just overwhelm you if you leave them alive, apparently. Because they just don't stop attacking. They don't stop! They're like Miley Cyrus right before she went super nutty during the the can't stop phase.
Can't stop, don't stop, yeah. Alright, where's that shot?
Can't stop, and we won't stop. Alright, everybody.
Jeez.
Bottoms up.
Oh, yeah, so I'm gonna go grab that Mountain Dew real quick. It's probably, what, 3 days old by now?
Sounds about right.
So it should be, like, moderately flat, right?
Should, in theory.
Now, I've stored it upside down, so let's give it a little test. I'm gonna open it up right in front of the mic, and we'll hear the... Yeah, with the drink upside down, there's no room for the carbon to escape.
Gotcha.
Alright, here we go. You ready?
Yep. Oh, we had the hiss.
Yep.
Good deal. So if you just store the bottle upside down, that makes sense. That makes a lot of sense, actually, because the gas is going to rise anyway.
Yeah, and it's as equally as carbonated as it was whenever I left it. I spent, like, all day just sipping on it, so. It's got carbonation, it's not a whole lot of it.
Gotcha.
But I can say it's the same amount that it was.
And I can say regular Captain Morgan is much better to shoot than,
Oh, yes.
That, too. Where did you come from? Where did you come from? Where did you go? Where did you come from? Crow creature thing.
Oh yeah.
We're
putting this on YouTube, so we're trying not to get any music flags.
Yeah. Not that my vocals were anywhere close to the actual song, but
when you started getting into the Cotton Eye Joe part, like, your accent was on point, I have to say.
Thank you, West Virginia.
Yeah, one of the props of growing up in one of the finest bluegrass states in the nation.
Yes, sir. Die!
There you go. I can't tell whenever there's more than one of them.
It's just a flurry of feathers. By perchance, is there any, like... You know how with Bloodborne that one cloak gave us some issues? Is there any of that with these guys?
Let me double check. So I'm watching on Skype, and with Skype there is, but it looks like the stream is actually really good.
Good deal.
What Alex is talking about is, in Bloodborne, We were having some difficulties testing because whenever we'd go through and he'd wear this giant like cape with a bunch of feathers on it, there would be pixelation drops around the movement of the cloak.
Right.
And
Oh my
we
God,
were
rush,
just
rush,
like,
rush, rush,
oh, nice. But you owe us a drink.
I know, but there's three of them coming at me, and
Oh,
that
jeez.
was so terrifying. I felt like the Scarecrow in the Wizard of Oz.
Wait, I don't blame the Scarecrow. There's lots of stuff to be afraid of. Do you know that was the first movie I was ever afraid of?
Really? You were terrified by the flying monkeys?
Not by the flying monkeys, not by the lions, not by anything else, but I was terrified of the wizard. When I
Really?
was like four, yeah, I was like, I would have to. I remember I'd get a pillow, which to me, like, as a 4-year-old, is probably bigger than my body.
Yeah.
But I'd have to get a pillow and angle it like against the couch and like go hide behind it. I was too afraid of the wizard.
Gotcha. So we got two NPCs here. Let's give them a chat.
All right.
Oh, hello.
Oh,
How do you think the excitement goes?
baby.
I am Anri of Astora,
Ooh.
unkindled
How you
like
doing,
you.
Henri?
This is Horace, a friend and traveling companion.
Just a friend, right?
Are you too in search of the
Oh,
Lord
yeah.
of Cinder?
Yes, ma'am.
We are well along the road of sacrifices.
Oh, is that what?
Below us is the Crucifixion Woods.
Road of Sacrifices in
Beyond the flying
Crucifixion
woods
Woods.
lies Farron Keep,
Okay.
home of the undead legions.
Gotcha.
Further
She's just
up,
fine hard to
the Eagle
get.
of the Deep.
Apparently.
We seek the cathedral, home of the grim Aldrich.
That's where we're heading.
We may go our separate
Yeah.
ways now, but we are both seekers of lords. The
Absolutely.
next time we cross paths, one may find the other in a time of need.
Yep,
May the
maybe.
flames guide your way.
And you as well.
You think that's a little bit of foreshadowing?
Maybe. What you got to say, big boy? I like his armor. He's got very no-nonsense armor on, just like straight
He's
up
got like
steel
a
plates.
BDSM helmet.
Yeah. What's up, bro?
Very barely chest
Yeah.
stomach thing. And he's got blue sentinels.
Yeah, but he doesn't speak, he just growls. He's just like. All right. I believe. Let me check real quick. We might have enough for a level up. We do. We have enough for one level. So let's go ahead and hop back and give that a look-see. Black hand armor. Very nice. Reminds me of the group in Elder Scrolls. I believe they're called the Black Hand, the Assassin Guild.
Oh, yes, that's right.
Well, hello, baby. I'm just getting all the women.
You're an unkindled, aren't you?
Yes, ma'am.
I am Cerys
Nice.
of the Sunless Realms, former
Is this
servant of the
a new one?
divinity.
Interesting.
Duties we each bear, but one's duty is a solitary affair.
Yeah.
I doubt we've much to gain from fraternization.
Aw, you don't want to talk? Well, fine. She's really playing hard to get.
Oh, that was one of the new people that you sent back to your keep. I just
She's
remember that
good
from
as
last time.
one.
All right, so infuse. No.
Pretty meet
Do
my
I
brother.
have any Estus Flask shards? I
Nothing's
do
good as
not
one.
believe I do. No. Didn't think so.
Welcome, host. Very
Level
well,
up.
then top hake nar.
This
So I've been
also
playing.
reminds me, I need to go back real quick to
Farewell,
the last area
Ashenwald.
we were at, because there was another path that I didn't go.
That's true. You still need to defeat the boss whenever you go, well, like after you've gone down the shaft.
I beat the boss. I beat the big tree, didn't I?
That was up. Yeah, that was up the shaft, not down in the basement, right?
There was no boss in the basement, it just led to the next area.
Oh, okay. My bad.
No, you're good.
These games confuse me whenever it comes to areas.
No, it's perfectly okay. I think Cliff Underside's the best place. Yeah, there was a whole nother path that I didn't go. I believe this is the best place to do it. If not, then I will get there promptly. It shouldn't be too big of an issue. So how's everybody doing today? We feeling good? We getting our drink on? Enjoying the Sunday evening?
Yeah, it sounds like today's going pretty well. I'll be, for any of you guys who are viewing in and don't really know how our setup works, basically Alex is playing this on the PS4.
Right.
And we're streaming it to Twitch. And because he's operating the game over there, I'm commentating and watching the stream and all the comments as well on the other end. But I've got a live feed of it up for myself personally, so I can commentate with Alex in live time and not have to wait on the lag that is Twitch.
Yeah, I think the way Twitch works is until you get your subscription button, they permanently make you have some aspect of lag, and once you get your subscribe button, you can turn that off and stuff.
Yeah. Absolutely. And even still, there's going to be a little bit of latency just because we have to send the stream to Twitch's servers and then they push it out.
I'm being stupid.
But it wouldn't be as bad as as it is without the subscribe button. So
right.
If you guys post any of your answers in the chat, or if you're watching this later on YouTube, feel free to tweet us or post in the comments. But if you're here live, you can post your comments in the chat and I'll read them out for you. And if you start getting a lot of them, I may have to skip a few, but donations are always a great way to get me to read every single one of them out.
Yes, absolutely. So I just realized there's another path from the tower, and we actually never went up into the tower before. So if I go back and travel to the bonfire right after the tower, I can just go back up the tower and press on from there. But I did have to rest at the bonfire, and the rats did a little damage, so technically I owe a drink, so cheers.
Cheers, guys.
Oh. Need a better chair for this. My back. Ugh. There we go. Just need to pop it a little bit. Pop it like a drop it.
Oh, yeah. That's the good stuff. Oh, speaking of good stuff. So I explained the cheap, fix for Jaeger trying out the first time.
Yes, we never got to your mixes.
Yes, my personal favorite mix that I found for Jaeger is, two to three shots of Jaeger. I like my drink strong. Very important. But then probably once you got that in the glass, about a quarter of the glass should be pineapple juice.
Ooh, really?
You put, yes, very tasty. Then you put in however many the amount of rocks or ice cubes that you want, and then fill the rest of the cup up with something sparkling like 7-Up or Sprite.
Huh, I would never have imagined mixing Jaeger with a light set of beverages.
Yeah, it's it doesn't really make sense until you try it, and it's very good. If I could just put up a hammock near a beach and just listen to the waves and drink that drink, I would do that every second that I get, every chance.
Really now?
Oh yeah, it's a great drink, and I love hammocks, but. You already know that.
Yes, we both are very fond of hammocks.
So whenever Alex and I went to college, Alex is a grade below me in school. So we went at different years, but we were both fortunate enough to be able to get positions at our respective universities as resident advisors. And for any
I just killed
girls,
myself. I did not kill myself.
Woo! That was a nice catch.
That was a lucky archway is what that was.
Yeah.
Okay, continue. Yes, resident advisorship.
Yeah, so we both, so for anyone out of country or isn't in college yet and doesn't know what that is, resident advisors are like the peer mediators inside of the dorms that are there to basically provide report for the younger students coming in. You can't be an RA and a freshman, so you have to have gone through your first year. And you're there to provide support for other residents, answer any questions, handle conflicts, guide them around, show them where all the facilities are on campus whenever they need them.
Right.
You know, participate in hall activities, things like that.
And also, there's all that stuff, which is, like, the main aspect of the job, but the, like, I feel like the most important is, like, mediating their social experience in their first year, making sure they're not being, like, super reclusive, and if they are having, like, issues with their roommates and stuff, being able to be there with them for that kind of thing. It's kind of like the dorm police in a way, but...
Yeah, so sort of like the dorm police, where there's a lot of administration tasks to it. Like if you're, almost every freshman is going to be underage.
Right.
And if you're in a freshman dorm, if they're drinking, you know, that's illegal for the state, so you have to report them for those sorts of things.
Right.
But also, like, if you've got a resident that's having problems with their roommate, or if they're just having any, like, mental hardships that they're going through.
Right.
And, it's kind of, you're the first responder in those cases. So, there's a lot of stuff that RAs do. But Alex and I were both given the opportunity. You drinking for us, bud?
I just drank.
Nice. So we were both fortunate enough to be RAs. And to celebrate, what we did is whenever I became an RA, Alex and I got together and made me a hammock completely out of duct tape.
Yes. Which, and it was awesome.
I guess we can tweet that out later.
Yeah.
I'll see if I can find a picture of it.
For sure.
Streaming. But, so we made myself one, and then the next year, Alex became an RA, and we got together and made him a duct tape hammock. Now we've got matching pairs of duct tape hammocks.
No. I am not getting one shot by you, bitches.
Oh, wow, that was close. There you go. Get those Mother Teresa's.
I'm actually just piecing out. They're way too strong to fight two of them at once right now.
Can that be, like, a new phrase for, like, a clean way to say motherfucker?
Just like, sure.
That damn Mother Teresa.
Yeah, I'm down for it.
My nerves.
Are they following me? No, they're too big to get through the doorway.
So, yeah, they are.
So this was the area I saw before, but I never went to.
Oh, gotcha.
You know, like, hop down here and, like, go into this tower. And there was one other place by... You remember where the guy was shooting the big arrows at us?
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay, looks like I can jump down onto that. Oh, a little too far back.
But now that you're in a safe place, aren't you always two drinks there?
I'm probably going to a few more.
I was looking through my pictures, and I was like, why do I have my two fingers up? Oh, that's right, Alex hasn't drank yet.
Okay, so I got arguably the best drink in the game right now. But two drinks, really? And I will explain, yes.
So I'm looking through my photos on my phone right now, and it looks like since we have made the hammocks, I have refreshed and, like, saved my photos. So I'll have to get off my computer and send it out. But we'll tweet out some of the photos for you guys.
Yes, duct tape hammocks are an amazing, amazing thing, and it was a lot of fun
awesome.
To make.
They are. They actually, believe it or not, get the ladies. Well,
they do. Because ingenuity and all that stuff.
Oh yeah, absolutely. You know, it's a good talking point.
Good talking point shows you know how to use your hands. Good all around. Mm-hmm. You're resourceful.
And you know, if you make a nice big hammock, it's good for snuggling.
Mm-hmm. And they're actually quite functional.
Actually, they're probably just as sturdy as the rope hammock, because duct tape is strongest in tension. If you're looking at, how do I explain this? Whenever you're looking at materials and material properties, duct tape has its largest strength in tensile forces. So it has a large tensile strength. Same thing with rope, right? Like, the more you pull it, the most it's going to be able to rely.
In layman's terms, the tighter it is, the stronger it is.
Basically, yeah. Sort of.
Sort of.
Because if you think of, like, pushing a rope together, it doesn't do anything. It doesn't resist. So there's no, compression strength with rope unless you coil it up. Anyway, regardless, they're both the strongest when you pull on them. So Duct Tape's tensile strength is actually pretty well up there to most types of ropes.
Really?
Yeah.
I can actually believe that, and that's not that hard to imagine. Cause...
Yeah, especially like the way you and I made the duct tapes. We layered the top and bottoms together, so it wasn't just one strand of duct tape. It was like four strand of duct tape, and then we weaved them in and out of each other.
I think weaved is the term, but I prefer the sound of wove, honestly.
We wove them together.
Yeah.
So they're both very strong. I've had like three or four people in my hammock. And it was fine.
Yeah. I haven't had very many people, but I've had some fairly big people in my hammock. And it's held up pretty well. So, I owe it one drink for sure.
Yep. There's you're missing out on all the fun ads over here on Twitch there, buddy.
Am I?
Yeah, I just refreshed the page just because it stalled out on me. They've constantly been showing this ad where it's for some, like, flexible notebook or like that. You know, like a tablet notebook.
Yeah.
And there's this girl in, like, almost a skin-tight, like, completely black uniform except for her head and her hands.
Yeah.
And she does a sideways aerial, which is basically a cartwheel without your hand.
Right.
And they show it from the same point of view the entire way through, except whenever she's upside down. And they go in slow motion, and the camera changes to be straight down on top of her, so you just see her crotch and her butt the entire time.
Oh, wow.
Zooms way back out.
Great advertising there.
Yeah.
I mean, sex sells, so.
That's true.
I don't know what that has to do with tablets, though, in all honesty.
I don't even know if it matters at this point.
Probably
maybe
not.
Maybe we should use some of those techniques for our channel.
Yes.
We're some up-and-coming young lads, and we're trying to figure out how to do well with the whole Twitch and YouTube thing. Maybe we can post pictures of ourselves in, like, banana hammocks and get some views that way.
Banana hammocks and perhaps some tool belts?
Yeah, I think that'd be great.
Banana hammocks, tool belts, get a little bit of oil going.
Yeah, that, down for it. We can have those sandwiches that you said you're going to tweet out later.
Yes.
Oh, do you want to tell the viewers about your sandwich?
Oh, yes. I have like a quad-decker peanut butter and banana sandwich.
Man,
like,
that sounds
like
good.
Five slices of bread, like three or four layers. I don't actually know how many layers because I didn't make it myself. But it just looks amazing.
That's,
and I cannot
right.
wait to have it later.
That for you, right?
Yes, they are very, very nice individuals who are fond of me, and they made me a sandwich because I asked.
Oh, nice.
Those guys like,
just
I was like, I'm hungry.
Sticks.
And they're like, wait, I got you.
That's awesome.
Yeah, they're just kind of using big pointy like logs, like tree branches. Like they could have just ripped it off of this tree right here and like,
They're not even whittled down or anything. They're not. I mean, I guess it's effective since they've got blood stains on, so they must have killed someone with them. But I'm not even trying to be creative. It's like big thing. Stab.
Ow!
Oh, jeez.
They hurt.
They're just as bad as the flying monkeys.
They hurt a lot. Alright, we'll drink for that.
Alright, bombs up, everybody.
Okay, so, we're in a swamp. Do we go the right path, down the middle, or go to the left?
What do you guys think of chat?
I'm going to destroy signs in the meantime. Or, I don't actually know what these are. They're like...
Oh, yeah.
They're like upside down peace signs that are like half made. But there's nothing
like,
peaceful here.
Looks like left.
Left? Okay. To the left, to the left.
Keep all my goodies in the box to the left.
So they brought
like
back
mushroom things.
They brought back the poison ticks. Well, it looks
oh.
like These were enemies from Dark Souls 2.
Their names sound worse than what they actually look like.
Yeah. That's just what I've always called them. I don't actually know what the names are, but... Yeah, they always look kind of tickish to me, but I can see the mushroom thing.
Right now would be a good time for that spear.
Yeah, just kind of poke them at a distance. You see, and then they do that and, like, kind of radiate cloud. And they can also nip at you, but it doesn't do a whole bunch of damage.
Gotcha. I was going to say, it'd be nice with the spear if you could do the horizontal swipe and just nab them all.
Yeah, that would be good. There's a guy with this. Okay. He's ready, but he's not pointing it at me.
Yeah, those zombies don't really have much in the brain department either.
No, it doesn't appear so. They kind of have to have it right in front of them to figure it out. Rotten pine resin. Nice.
Does that add deep your weapon?
No, that adds poison.
Oh.
The resin that adds deep to battle axe is called human pine resin.
That's right.
Hey! 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 Calm down. No, no, no. Ow.
Oh, they are swarming
oh,
you.
Oh. And this dog is gonna be the death of me. Unless I kill it now. No!
That's a shot. For those of you playing at home, we got one drink for every heal and one straight up shot for every death.
Starting out real good. Starting out real good. Let me tell you right now. Alright. Cheers.
At least the shot's nicer this time than it was last time.
Yeah. Straight Captain Morgan's just delicious, no matter what way you put it. Like, that nice, like, burny vanilla is just,
Oh, yes, yes.
So...
How are you feeling over there, bud? You starting to...
I'm getting warm-cheeked, yeah.
Getting that Asian glow.
Yeah.
He's saying that was probably more offensively.
Come on. There we go. So, I actually want to get a few souls, and I want to go level up a weapon of some type. What materials do I have?
Yeah, I don't think you have leveled up a weapon yet.
I have not, and I need to, because I'm feeling like my damage is a bit on the lacking side, and that's... part of the reason why I'm doing the dance.
I guess if you're going to invest material in leveling a weapon, you kind of need to know what build you're going to go for first, right?
Yeah. I'd still honestly like to go kind of a quality style build going back and forth between strength and dex.
Right, but I mean, just so you know which, like, kinds of weapons you're going to be upgrading. Or does not work that way? Do you use different materials for different types of weapons?
It depends on the weapon. Like, this weapon I'm using right now uses Twinkling Titanite, which I don't actually have any of.
Okay.
Because it's special. I saw you come in there. But,
that was a good eye.
Regular weapons and stuff just use the regular Titanite, so I have a bunch of those right now, I think. Yeah, I've got 16 regular Titanites, so...
Is that a lot?
Well, it takes 12 to get a weapon to +3. So I can get one weapon to +3, and then one weapon leveled up once.
Gotcha, okay. So, I think that the spears have been working the best for you.
Gotcha. Oh, I also... Okay, so you know how I got that one spear from the tree, right? I used its soul to make the super pointy spear, which I have actually yet to pull out and show anybody.
Yeah, because you're just waiting for it.
Here's the spear.
Yep. It looks just like it did whenever you battled, but if anyone's joining in right now, this is a pretty sweet spiral.
Which I can actually use that right now.
Oh, you leveled up enough?
Yes, the last level.
Hell yeah.
What's the damage compared to the regular spear? Okay, so it is stronger than the partisan.
Right.
Okay, so I'm gonna...
You have the same attack pattern with as you do with a partisan?
I get a big poke there. Do I have any swipe moves? I do not believe so, unless...
Yeah, this looks more like the pole arm.
Oh, okay, and I'm fat rolling. Yeah, the partisan is a pole arm. You're thinking the lucerne.
Yes, sorry.
The lucerne's the one that has the nice big swipe.
No, I'm thinking of the spear. I think the partisan's the one that you've been doing the best with. It also has a horizontal.
Oh, yes. Okay. You're absolutely right. Okay. So the boss spear that I have is just nothing but poke.
Yeah. It's acting like a halberd, I think.
No, I'm not 100%. I think the partisan is actually acting semi like a halberd in itself. Am I fat rolling now? I am still fat rolling. Crap.
You got a new shield, didn't you?
Yeah, I just de-equipped it, though, because it's heavy. Okay, so that's going to make me not fat roll. Can I put on the new shield? Okay. So if I want to use this spear, which I kind of do just to try it out, we're good now. Awesome.
Okay.
But yeah, this one's straight up pole arm. Oh, this shield. Yes, I did just get a new shield. It's a great shield. The Twin Dragon Great Shield, to be precise. And I just kind of hold it up in front of my crotch.
Oh, cool.
Protects me from the waist down, and I can see over top
like
of it.
Holding a shield at that angle wouldn't, like, help at all.
Yeah, he's very nonchalantly holding it. It's kind of weird, in all honesty. I don't really like the animation for it, so I'm not going to use it. Like,
there you go.
Like, this here just seems much more like...
Yeah, you get your whole arm into it, you're using your shoulder to...
And it actually blocks your entire body besides, like, maybe a shin.
Yeah.
Okay, so we are over towards this house. Let's go test this baby out.
On some guys with other pointy sticks.
Okay,
it doesn't
so
look like it's
it doesn't hit like... as hard as the ice... sword does currently.
Right.
But it does have the range advantage from what it looks like.
It is a little slower.
Yeah, so I'm thinking the ice sword is still the best bet to go currently. I also got the scythe back in the village.
Oh, that's right.
So there's a good look at that.
Well, that's a whole lot of range. But it's really weak, isn't it?
It's fairly weak right now, yes. Everything else that I have is basically stronger than it, besides maybe the butcher knife. So yeah, I'm gonna use the ice sword for now.
Okay.
Just until I can get back and, level up. I didn't actually grab my souls from back here when I died. I need to go back for that.
Ooh, yes you do.
And hopefully not die in the same tragic way I did before.
I'll have to make you that Jaeger mix the next time I come visit.
Absolutely. That sounds delicious.
Yeah. Yummy, yummy, yummy. In my tummy.
Yes, sir. Okay, so... I think right... Am I... dog? Hello? No. You.
There you go. Get it!
Come on. They have so many invincibility frames as they're standing back up. Okay, yeah, so it still takes 3 to kill them with this sword. It takes 4 to kill them with the boss spear.
Yeah.
Which is
fine. I think
fine.
That boss spear would have probably been nice, like, when you got it. But now it's been a little while, you know.
Yeah.
It's not for your build.
Right. Plus, so you know that big crystal dinosaur thing I killed right at the very beginning, right?
Yeah.
They drop Titanite Scales, and that's what you use to level up boss weapons. So I could actually probably get away with leveling it up whenever I get back.
Oh, the sword or the spear?
The spear.
Gotcha.
Okay, so where... I know it was right around in here. Where is my...
Is it not the bloodstain you just walked past?
Yeah, but it wasn't mine. It's not like it should have like a little glowy thing on top. There it is.
To the left. There you go.
Okay, so you did see it, and I was just oblivious.
It's all good. It was hard to see.
Yeah. All right, let's go into this. Let's go around this building and then go into this building because it looks very interesting.
Sounds like a plan.
Sounds
so
like
I've been
plan.
Playing. So I've been in my personal time. I've been playing through Wind Waker again.
Wind Waker, that's the one with Toon Link, right? That's the cartoony,
yes.
Cel-shaded one.
Yeah, and you know, it might be one of my favorite.
Ooh, Estus Shard, nice.
It's definitely one of my favorite Zeldas. It might be my favorite. It's between that and
really?
Ocarina of Time, yeah. I think the reason
most people, it's Ocarina of Time or Link to the Past, so that's interesting.
Well, I think what does it for me is the fact that in games in general, I don't really like dungeons. I don't like dungeon crawlers. And I have not yet figured out what it is about dungeon crawlers that I don't like. It's just something purely atmospheric that I don't like. But Wind Waker, the majority of the time it takes place outside, and even in a lot of dungeons, you go from being inside to being outside to like having these nice glowing areas. I think that's what really makes me enjoy it, is just because I like the atmosphere mid-game.
Gotcha. Yeah, it's settled again.
That would do it.
Yeah. So you're a more open world style guy instead of dungeon crawler-esque.
Wholeheartedly, yes.
That's fair. You see, I can take it or leave it, whether it's a dungeon crawler or an open world. I just enjoy exploration.
I like open sandbox games for the most part, but even the ones like Fallout and Skyrim, where there's a large majority of where you are in a dungeon type setting, like it. I usually don't finish those games.
Whoa!
After a while, I get a little bored. Wow. That was quite the shot.
Yeah, there's a mage.
Is that another storyteller, dude?
Hey man, nice shot. I don't know who does that song, but now it's stuck in my head.
Hey man, stam.
There we go.
It's so satisfying if you could get like a downward stab onto them.
Yeah, it does kind of like an outward, like, straight sword drop, like you're trying to, like, scissor them in half with it.
Yeah.
I think with the spears, you actually do get, like, a downward stab drop, though.
Ooh, nice.
I actually want to test that out, see what the animation looks like. Just for shiggles.
There you go. And let's see. Any hop, any stab.
Yes, it is a downward stab. Okay, so that's the animation you were looking for, right?
Yeah, it's actually different than I was expecting, but basically, yeah.
What were you expecting?
I was expecting to like have him turn his hand around and stab in, but push it down that way makes more sense so you don't have to re-grip the weapon.
Yeah, I hear ya. Ow, ow!
He was happy until you started attacking him.
Yeah, I should have just left him alone, but no. This is an RPG. You murder everything in your path unless it talks to you.
Absolutely, and even then, still sometimes.
Yeah. Alright, so... going to the second portion of this building. Hello there. I see you. Shaking that ass.
Moving around in a circle.
Yeah. Alright. What's this say? Be wary of right. Okay. Well, we're
so
going to the right
go
then.
To the right.
Lizard!
There you go. Be wary of it, though. It's a lizard.
No! Lizard! Lizard!
Oh, the things you do for lizards. Actually, there's only one enemy. Which is nice.
Got a crystal gem. It wasn't worth it.
It was only worth one drink, anyway.
Yeah.
Jeez.
Okay. Okay, so we got a sorcerer out there and a spear guy. Sorcerer's going first, because he could potentially do the most damage, I think.
Yeah.
And he hit me with a stick.
Yeah, nice charged up attack with a stick, too.
There There we go.
At least these guys don't have very much health.
Yeah, that is nice.
So
yeah.
Still owe us one drink.
Yes, I owe you one drink. And that lizard dropped a crystal gem, which crystal in this game is magic imbuing. So you can imbue a weapon with magic so that it scales off your intelligence.
Oh, okay.
This build's not building. This build's not going magic, so it's fucking useless.
Gotcha.
I need them to start dropping twinkling titanite. That's what I really need.
But now, can you sell that component then for a little bit more money?
Yes, you can.
All right, so it wasn't a complete waste.
Not completely, but it all depends on how much I can get out of it, which I don't think is going to be a whole lot. Okay, so what do we got here? A ring of sacrifice. So rings of sacrifice in this game, you equip them, and if you die, then the ring breaks, but you don't lose your souls. But you can't use the ring ever again. It's just gone.
Right. So now you've got two of those.
Yes, I have two of those. So if I stumble across a boss and I'm not ready, I'm just going to try to throw that on. Actually, nah, I'm not going to put one on right now. Just because. I don't think I'll need it. Okay, so be wary of right. Hello there.
Very nice.
And there is a hole in the floor that does lead to stuff. Don't want to drop into it because it looks like a trap. Hello there.
Just jump before you can stand up. That's how you do it.
Okay, another mage. Are you gonna? Yep. He tried to power attack me. Tall. Yes, they are.
And down he goes. Floppy
yes.
hat and everything.
Okay, so that's a
just
straight
his skirt.
That's a straight drop down. Don't want to drop down there just yet. I want to explore the rest of this room. Ouch!
Oh jeez.
No!
Oh no.
Where did you come from?
Alright. Well, that's another shot.
I'm so irritated. The ambush. Where did the mage come from?
That's been like a recurring theme in this section of the game. You just keep on getting ambushed by enemies like the freaking monkey birds, the dog, and all the spear guys in the graveyard. All
yeah.
these guys.
I don't get it. But anyway, cheers, everybody.
Woo, cheers.
Okay.
Bottoms up, your throat's on fire.
Good parody. I like that.
Thank ya.
Come on. Please, just... There we go.
I feel like this level would be good for, like, area damage-based magic.
Yes.
Like splash damage.
Get some good splash AoE going.
Yeah.
Okay, so what I'm gonna do, I don't want to fight through everything again. I'm just gonna kind of try to choose the path of least resistance and work my way back over there. So this guy, he can suck a big one.
Oh yeah.
And
you got that.
Ah. There's always somebody to ruin my good time. In this game,
at least you're not to the point where you're like trying to speed run through it.
No, I'm not just aggroing everything in my path and just have like a parade. I saw you.
There's that puppy again.
I saw him.
He was being a bad puppy. He was a bad puppy.
And, okay, where is... Oh, hi Bonfire. Have you always been there and I just didn't notice? That's significantly closer.
Probably because we went to the left instead of straight through.
Yeah, what the...
Ooh, giant crab monster.
Giant enemy crab.
This is all kinds of new.
There's like four blood stains down there and an item.
Oh, don't you know there's lots of blood stains down there, laddie.
Yeah, so I'm assuming he's a little tough. Where are you? I hear
what,
you.
Is he tougher than you? Is he tougher than you?
I have no clue. I would not put it past me at this point.
Oh, okay.
Just because Dark Souls has a way of putting like really strong enemies just randomly in places to like troll people.
Oh yeah. I like how like the stereotypical like getting someone pumped up just doesn't work in Dark Souls. There's been too many defeats. Like, yeah, you gonna get him? Probably not.
If you want my honest answer, I'm probably gonna get my shit pushed in all the way up to my mouth and be vomiting excrement.
Gotcha. That is quite vivid.
Hey, I can be gruesome too. You had it all last time, so
I did,
it's my
I
turn.
Did.
Okay, so I remember you. Bada bing, bada boom. Okay. Okay, so this is the room. There's that guy there. That's not the guy that ambushed me. That's the guy I killed.
That's correct.
So there's another guy.
Maybe with that message that says beware of the right. Maybe there's a guy directly to the right. Fucking, yeah.
Yeah, but this wasn't the guy that killed me. This isn't the guy that,
like,
just...
I feel like the guy that killed you was after you cleared out all these initial enemies.
It was. So I killed that guy. I killed this guy before he stands up. I walk around. We got Mr. Big Hat. I stab him in the ass. And then I smash him to bits. I get ambushed from behind.
Oh, you're getting sandwiched.
Yep. There he is! He comes out of that path. Okay, I got my souls back.
Yep, you got good health.
I got good health.
Got all your Estus flasks.
And butt stab.
There you go. Good old fashioned butt stabbing.
And Mr. Big Hat is no more.
Bada bing, bada boom, and
I got one of their staffs.
Nice. It looks like Dark Souls is pretty good about like sharing the wealth when it comes to weapons.
Yeah, absolutely. And with this game, they actually put a stat into the game, the luck stat, which actually increases drop rates.
Oh, that's what luck does. I
it increases drop rates. It increases the. Or decreases the amount of hits it takes to apply, like, bleeds or poisons. Be wary of bloodstain. Try ambush, therefore, if only I had friendship. We have a boss fight. I guarantee this is a boss fight. This is way too big and open.
We don't need people to help us out with the boss fights, though.
No, I kinda... I'm gonna finish...
By we, I mean you.
By we, yes. I'm gonna finish exploring this house, I think. So I've already been down there. I know where that is. That's the one that looped around and got me the Ring of Sacrifice.
Right.
The only other place to go is down in the hole.
Ooh,
feeling so
go
small.
Down the hole. Or can you break any of those doors open to your left? There's a wooden area. Maybe it was just the bookshelf that I saw.
Yeah, I think you just saw bookshelves and they're not smashable.
Right.
Fuck it, boss time.
You're not going down the hole at all?
I'll go down the hole after, because usually bosses drop bonfires, so I'll just rest at the bonfire and then go straight down the hole. I feel like dropping that in a hole is a bad idea, and there's going to be like three things down there that are going to gangbang me.
Alright, well let's do it.
And so, me being Alex of the male persuasion, I only have two orifices, so if it's a gangbang with more than two people, then I'm they're going to have to make a hole.
Yep, and looking at all their weaponry, they probably can.
Ow!
And probably just make three new holes and start using those.
Ow. Okay, I need to back off and heal. Already. So it looks like this is a super mage.
Yep. Shooting crystals. He looks pretty epic, too. Like, he looks very magey.
Yeah, gigantic hat, nice long flowing cape.
Yes, very
apparently
flowy.
Apparently he teleports. Oh, hello there.
There we go. Trying to distance himself from you.
Okay, so he's about half health already. He does not have very much health, which is also very mage-esque.
Yes. You're making short work of him.
And he's over here now.
Do you think the fact that your weapon has element status on it is doing less damage to him.
I would assume it does more, but
how does the attack stack up with this? Is it like you got a base level attack?
Oh, there's multiple. There's no.
Oh jeez. Oh no. Oh no. That's two drinks and a shot. Or was that three drinks? Because you got a plus one.
I don't know. I was nice. I had six going in.
Yeah, but it also said plus one on it.
The plus one is like the like how much it heals. Like each drink heals four. So
gotcha. Well, we'll go with two.
Okay.
Actually, it is two. Yeah. Uh-oh. Cheers, fellas.
Cheers.
And ladies. Tasty over there?
Yeah.
Nice.
That's a word for it. No, it's actually delicious.
Why did you... Oh, okay, that is the new bonfire, okay.
Yes, that's the new bonfire.
It looked like the old one, so I was confused by that.
You shot a spell at me. I'm tired of mages.
Stop shooting at me, it's really irritating.
I don't like the pew pews. I just want a duel. Okay, so I'm gonna kill this spear guy here. And so I'm gonna work my way around and then I know where the second mage is at now. I was originally thinking about just running for it, but that doesn't work in these games.
That hasn't worked too well in the past.
Nah, that just
gets... Also, how do you get that item up there on the top?
I'm assuming dropping down will eventually take me to the top.
Okay.
It's just an assumption, but I feel like it's a good one.
Sure, yeah, I mean, it's worked in the past. There's that big fucker.
There's a guy doing stabbies. Come on. What is he fighting over there?
Looks like he keeps on banging his big toe against the rocks over there. Just keeps getting angrier and angrier.
Yeah, apparently. Okay.
Whatever.
Okay, both the mages are out here now. Hey! Are they trying to... Ow!
Come fight me like the bitch you are!
Ow. Okay, there's... I feel like this is a fine opportunity for me to make a run for it. Because they're all right here.
Sure. I mean, it's your call.
Ow!
It has to be said that you do play this game a lot better than I do.
Yes. Okay, so I made it. First order of business. Where the fuck is my souls? They're over here. I'm gonna go get them. I got them.
Oh, very nice. I like that there's no, like, time setup that you have to, like, wait while you're getting your souls.
No, it's all just... No! Oh, no, geez. That hurts so bad! That hurts so bad!
I don't think I've seen that attack yet.
No, it's very slow moving, but... It hurts so bad.
It's like water mines.
Yeah. Okay, so the crystals pop up and he's teleporting. Where is he gonna be? Where is he gonna be? Where is he gonna be?
Where is he going? There he is.
Oh, this guy hurts so bad. All of his spells are just extremely, extremely dangerous.
Alright, now go wound fuck him. Do it.
I gotta wait for these little homing things around them to come at me. Okay. Progress. I need to be much faster on actually finding him.
Or you can just, like, make sure you have enough time to dodge those giant spells. Although that is very effective when you find him fast.
Yes, if I can find him fast, I feel like I can rush him down before he can actually channel a spell.
There he is. Yep. It takes a little bit of time. Now he's at half health. Is this whenever he?
This is when he's gonna start spawning the clones.
That's not louder. Oh, yeah. Oh man, there are a lot of clones. Woo! Gotta dodge. There we go. Oh jeez.
No.
Oh my. Oh golly. Oh jeez.
This is not fun.
Oh, no.
Is there anything I'm missing? Like, is there a difference between him and the clones that I'm just not seeing?
The only thing that I saw is that this one is the only one that's doing purple magic.
I'm gonna need you to help me then.
Okay. Oh, that's right. I always forget for a split second.
Okay, so looking for purple.
Looking for purple. Alright. Very far one to your left.
Oh shit.
The guy who just did the giant line towards you.
Yep.
There he is. So for those of you guys who don't know, Alex is colorblind. Is that him?
Yes, that was him. Okay.
Nice. Okay, so we'll keep going with that.
Yes, need purple. Need. Not him. Is it this guy? I feel like it's this guy.
Up to the right. Left, there you go.
Holy shit, I am so good at this fucking video game. One hit! Yes!
There you go. Nice.
Oh, that was... That last dodge was a pure luck dodge, and it dodged, like, every single spell they casted at me at once.
It was like, they all hit you right when your god frames came up.
Oh my god. That was actually a really fun mage fight.
Good teamwork on our part.
Yes, absolutely. So, Dark Souls has never been known for having, like, good mage fights. Normally, the mage fights are the pushovers of the game.
Yeah. I guess they made sure it's not this time.
Yeah, they definitely did. Oh, god. God damn. Okay, so how were you counting? I went through them all, didn't I?
You went through all of them, so you owe us six.
Okay. That's pretty well finishing my drink at this point. I'll count them down like the mouthfuls, and if I need more, I'll be good.
All right, bottoms up, game bro.
I have like a drink and a half left in this.
Oh, nice.
Okay. So,
for any of you guys who are joining us, we call ourselves and the viewers game bros, game brethren, even the ladies.
Even the ladies.
Yep.
Okay, so.
Because we're all bros.
Yes. So I want to level stuff up. I want to get some stronger weapons.
So while you're doing that, I'm going to explain why I brought up Wind Waker earlier.
Okay.
So in Wind Waker, I don't know if it was just my build of the game or what, but I didn't realize that whenever you go into like the naming convention, there's like some spacing in there already from where the preset name was. But it started off with a bunch of spaces for me, and I didn't backspace out of them before I wrote my name down. But now they're just like, my name is like right justified, but they're with spacing. So there's like four spaces in front of my name.
Yeah.
And every time I just named myself Link. But every time whenever I'm talking with an NPC and they say my name, it sounds like I'm in a soap opera.
Oh, that's kind of cool though.
Yeah, you are certainly our hero, Link. Hey, so your name is Link. I've heard of you. Can you go fetch me some droid pendants, Link? There's always a dramatic pause. Say, Link, thank you for saving our daughter.
So do me some math. What's 152 minus 136? What's the difference between those two?
It's going to be something with a 6 in it. 126, I think? 116, maybe?
No, I meant like if you, like, the difference, it should be in, like, the 20s range, I think.
Oh, it's 116. So, oh, wait, what?
Like, subtract 152, like 136 from 152.
16.
16? Okay, yeah. So what's the difference between 64 and 41? Am I getting more damage by refining it, is what I'm saying?
23.
Okay, so yes, if I refine it, I do get more damage out of it.
Yes, sir.
Okay, we will refine. I'm gonna make the broadsword my, like, go-to weapon if I need something.
Mm-hmm.
Just because it seems like a pretty cookie-cutter standard weapon.
Yeah, that's true.
So it's actually stronger than my ice right now, so I'm gonna go ahead and throw it on. But
nice.
I started leveling up the partisan spear, the one with the big swipey thing. I'm honestly not the hugest fan of the boss weapon, unfortunately.
Yeah, I was hoping it'd be closer to the partisan.
You see, I like AoE attacks, and it doesn't have that, so I'm a little disappointed.
Yeah.
Let's go see what our boss soul gives from Mr. Crystal Sage.
Oh, that's right. That's right.
So we can either get a rapier that scales off of magic.
So probably not.
Or a spell.
Oh, can you not just eat it?
I can eat it, which I'm definitely going to do because both of those for this build sound bad.
Nom 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 nom.
Yes, I have. I have quite a few levels actually.
Ooh, nice.
Let's eat all the souls that we have in our inventory, like we're Shang Tsung.
You got so many different bits of jewelry and armor. You can just open up your own shop.
That would be nice. Yeah, just start selling my trinkets off here and there.
Yeah, how funny would it be for a game to, like, I'm sure most open sandboxes you could do this with are MMOs, but how funny would it be to, like, just have a game where you're on this, like, giant quest for, like, one goal-oriented purpose, and you just stop in the middle to, like, pick up a random hobby.
Yeah. Sounds like Skyrim, only, like, even more random, like, becoming a jewelry salesman.
Sounds exactly like Fallout, right? Because your wife gets murdered in front of your eyes and your son gets stolen and you're on this adventure to go find him and then you're just like, no, I'm gonna go raise a new village and do all this other stuff.
I'm gonna go build a town, start a caravan network.
I'm just gonna be a farmer forever.
Yeah, pretty much. Okay, so we have 7 flasks now, so the amount of drinking has went up.
Woo!
I leveled up my health and my endurance, and I have both dexterity and strength at 20.
Nice. Pretty solid numbers.
Pretty solid numbers. Okay, so we will go back to the Crystal Sage boss arena. And after a few more drinks, I will go freshen up. We're going to go see what's down in the hole.
All right, time to go down the hole.
And if I looked correctly, once we get in here, I'll check just to make sure. It looked like there's a path that we could go in behind this area. That might be the next place to go.
Right, I saw that as
yes,
well.
Right here. Okay, so yeah. We can go that way. That's probably the next place to go. I want to finish exploring the swamp first, though.
I agree. And we also, you never went to the right from the first bonfire.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. That's part of the swamp. I want to go back and, like, just check it out and make sure I'm not missing anything super duper good.
So we're going to go down the hole and then go back to the swamp.
Yes. And I figure I can go from the right of this building and just work my way around the outer rim.
Yeah. Rim it up real good.
I mean, I've never tried a rim job, but we can give it a go here.
All right. Alex's first rim job, guys. You're here to see it.
All right. Yeah, so
maybe not a rim job.
Nah.
That would be quite the stream, wouldn't it?
That would be illegal on Twitch, actually.
Oh, yeah. I guess that would just be porn at that point.
Yeah.
If you guys wanted us to make a porn
maybe
channel,
maybe
so
my
you,
free
let us know in the comments below.
Yes, that is exactly what I anticipated when I jumped down here.
Yep, he's got those red eyes, too. Pluck him out. There you go.
Ouch.
Oh, jeez. My goodness.
Okay, two drinks.
Maybe he's not a man. Maybe it's just a thing. Whatever it is, it looks hungry.
And it's dead.
There we go. He should have had a Snickers.
He should have had a Snickers. He was a little perturbed when he's hungry.
Ooh, sorcerer stuff.
Okay,
you also owe us two drinks, sir.
Yes, and that will be enough to finish this drink off. So, I am, I'm gonna have Alex take a nap while I go fresh my drink. I shall return shortly.
All right, guys, I hope you've been enjoying the stream so far. This is always fun for Alex and I to do, and it's probably one of our most enjoyable segments that we do currently. You know, we just get to sit down, have a few drinks, chat with you guys, and it's really a lot of fun. But we both know that, we might want to be a little bit flexible in, how we get some more viewers, what you guys like to see, what you don't like to see. So please feel free to reach out to us any way that you want, any way that you can. Hit us up on Twitter. Hit us up on YouTube. We don't have a Reddit currently. But if you guys want to see us get a Reddit, just let us know. We can make that happen. And, just let us know what you guys think. I hope you guys are having as much fun as we are. Let's see, what else is on the agenda for tonight? So we had a new segment come out on YouTube called Have You Seen This? And basically, you know how whenever, you hang out with friends or even siblings and stuff and you find a game or a movie that's either really cool or just is terrible and you want to make them suffer through it, basically you go to them and say, hey, have you seen this? Check it out. Like, this is awesome. And so what we're doing on that is, like, if one of us has heard of a game or a movie or something that the other one hasn't, we will set up either a viewing station, or we'll set up something where the other person goes sit down and play the game for the first time and really just kind of introduce them to that. So we had our first video come out of that where, I show Alex what Trackmania is. And if you guys have any ideas for games that you want us to see or that you want to introduce us to, we can try that out. Just, again, let us know what you want to see, what you want to hear. You more than happy to oblige. Looks like Alex is still hanging out, sitting down. What else is on the agenda tonight? We've got our new schedule figured out. It's going to be basically the same schedule that we've had, where on Mondays we're having our original series called Misadventures. And then on Tuesdays and Thursdays we're playing through Final Fantasy 1. Wednesdays we're going through Tales of Symphonia, which is my first time playing through the game. And then we have moved our survival series over to Saturday, where we're going to have Survival Saturdays. It's going to be lots of fun. Looks like Alex is back.
Mom, yep, I'm back.
You get something to eat?
Yeah, I got that sandwich.
Nice.
If y'all are curious about how epic this sandwich is, I just tweeted a picture of it. It's quite luxurious and amazing.
Oh, I've got to check this out.
And I counted it out. It's it's four slices of bread in five layers.
Oh my goodness, that looks awesome.
Peanut butter nanner time for the win.
Oh man, now I'm getting hungry.
Well, if you need to go get yourself a pick-me-up, feel free. That big crab's coming towards me. Is it gonna come in here?
I don't know.
It's gonna try.
Yeah, I can stick his claw in there. That is one fast crab.
Well, I'm just gonna use a homeward bone and just peace out of. I cannot. Why can't I peace out? Did I get invaded? Am I invaded right now?
Ooh. Maybe.
Little crap, piss off!
Do I. Not,
I am invaded right now.
Oh, I've been invaded by a watchdog. Is that your cousin?
No. This is
some random guy.
This is a random.
All right.
Crap, go away. Please. Just leave me alone.
How far away from you is he or she?
I don't know. They're somewhere.
Do they just have to walk around and find you?
Yeah.
Can invaders help you with, like, your crab fight?
No. No, they can't. And I can't get past this crab, I don't think.
Nope.
Go! No! Don't die!
Geez,
there's the invader, too. Fuck.
That crab is fast.
Die fast, please. Okay.
There you go.
That guy did see me. He saw me come in here.
All right, you gonna battle him?
I'm gonna try. Hello?
Doesn't look like it's any of our viewers, so I mean, go for it.
Why do people? Oh no, I'm gonna fucking lose. God damn it.
Do the invaders have access to their Estus flasks?
They have access to half. There he is.
Alright. Watchdog of Farron.
Yes, his name is Caius. Get down here! I just want to get this over with.
Yeah, pretty cool cape.
Yeah, I'm scared.
He's just taunting you with a shield.
I'm not stupid.
Is that the Dark Souls way to like flip you off? Oh, there you go. Nice.
Don't go and use the fucking enemies to try to make me lose, please. Just come in here and fight me. Don't be a twat.
You don't have to do anything that he wants you to.
Yeah, but he's making it so that I
mean, he's the one that invaded you. If he wants to fight you, he's gonna have to come in and get you.
Yeah, but there's not really anything that's making it so that he has to.
Oh, nice! So close.
And got him.
Bam! He didn't even try to heal.
Wrecked mofo.
Way to go. And you owe us 2 drinks, probably going to be 3 here in a second.
Yes, it is going to be 3, but the cool thing about killing invaders in this game is you get Estus flasks back for killing them.
Woo! What's so that every... thing sticking out of your shoulder?
Eh? I think that's just a little jetting piece
of
armor.
Oh, that's your shoulder plate thing. It was just,
yeah,
it was,
it's to keep like blades from coming up and catching me in the neck.
Yeah.
So yeah, anytime you kill an invader in this game, you get 2 Estus flasks back for your efforts.
Nice.
And for you, I don't think you know this, Titch, but I actually, in Dark Souls 2, I was very avid in the PvP community.
I did not know that.
Yes,
I think, well, maybe you mentioned it once, but I don't remember it.
I was quite active. I did a lot of PvPing, so I know my way around the sword and board.
Nice.
So I owe, how many was it?
2.
Okay.
3. Sorry, 3.
Which one is it?
It was 2 for the fight and the third one after the fight.
Right, okay, so 3. Yeah.
Tasty.
I messed up on this one. That's all I'm gonna say.
Oh man, it's gonna be fun once it settles down and like it's tasting good, and then you finally get to the bottom again.
Shut up. Okay, so now that I'm not invaded anymore, I will use that homeward bone. I don't have enough souls to level up, but I'm gonna use that homeward bone to get back to the bonfire. I'm gonna take another bite of my delicious sandwich.
And then are we gonna go on to the new area, or did you still want to explore the right side of the swamp?
We're gonna explore the swamp.
How do you get that that item though? That was on the top, because when we went down the hole, you never were able to go back up.
Hmm.
I sense a little bit of parkouring.
Let's find out.
For any of you fellow game bros or new watchers, by any means, don't play Minecraft. Those noises that Alex and I are making are like noises that the villagers in Minecraft make. They're very irritating, but they get contagious very quickly as well.
They're extremely fun to emulate.
Yeah. Okay. They stand around with their giant, like, Squidward noses going,
So there's, I think this, I don't believe I went around this way. I think this might, yes, this goes up.
Yes. Good call.
I saw it, but I didn't think I had actually went. Oh! Hi.
Hey, it's a person. Okay, a bunch of pages. I could very easily be set on fire by that candelabra.
What do you want?
Or that thing, if you set on fire.
This is my study that you've happened upon.
Uh-huh.
If you haven't any business...
This is my study.
I have reading to get back to.
In the middle of all these monsters.
If you don't have any business, I have reading to get back to, with a whole bunch of hollows just gyrating around downstairs.
Yeah.
Ask to learn sorceries? Sure.
How intriguing.
Why not?
You better not.
What's that supposed to mean?
For everyone. And should
this is calling you stupid.
You have your own methods. Sorcery need not be one of them. Don't let it bother you.
Don't let it bother me. I'm taking it extremely personal.
You're unkindled. Shouldn't you get back to your duty?
Don't you tell me what to do!
You gonna kill him? Do it.
Don't you tell me what to do!
Do it. Kill.
No. I don't like killing NPCs in these games just because they might come back later and be helpful. But I'm gonna fucking wreck his ship. Have fun reading now, asshole.
Oh, they went everywhere.
What? He looks quite pissed.
Have you talked to him again? Does he know that all of his stuff was just destroyed?
I thought you'd already given up.
No, just...
Well, nothing has changed. You're not. It is either be on your...
There. All your stuff's broken. Have fun reading now.
Oh, I gotta pick it all up off the floor.
Alright. And I bet down these stairs is that item that you was talking about. Yep.
Yep.
Blue bug pellets.
There you go.
So bug pellets in this game temporarily increase your resistances to certain elements. I'm assuming blue increases your resistance to frost.
That sounds like a good plan. I guess. Can you just keep that guy?
Where did you?
Here, there's him again. What's that like crescent moon symbol on the cross? Is it reoccurring? I mean, it is in this game.
I mean,
but, like, has it been reoccurring in the past games?
No. This one doesn't have as heavy of a crescent moon. I'm not sure if it's just like damage to
it. It's on like all of those things. Like,
okay, so this guy's getting up. He wants to tussle.
He does. There you go. Nice.
I used up all of my stamina and couldn't get that last swing in for the kill.
That's true. But now you can hit him.
If I can hit him. There we go.
There you go.
Okay, so, we need to go this way into the swamp.
Yes, sir.
So I'm gonna go, the bonfire's right over here. I will drink for this, because I have been damaged. And, we will explore the left portion of the swamp. Do you want me to go back to the bonfire, like the first bonfire, and work my way around that outer rim, or should I just continue around this side?
I think you just continue around this side. I mean, I don't think you're going to run into the crowd anyway.
I hope not, because that thing is mean. And I didn't...
It is
I didn't,
fast.
I didn't hit it. It's right there! What do you mean I'm not going to run into it? It's right there! And there's two of them!
I thought you were going to go forward from where you were at.
Oh, we could do that. That's fine.
Or you can just go kill the crabs.
But the crabs... Yeah. Mr. Krabs, leave me alone.
Really fast, though.
It's it. No. No. This is. This is. No. 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 No.
Get out of there. Get out of there.
Okay, right, dog.
There you go.
Dog, mirror.
Gain some composure. Kill that dog. I'd be interested to see how your firebomb works on the crab.
The firebombs?
Yeah. Those are your ranged weapon that you've got equipped right now, correct?
No, I have a buff equipped right now. Okay. I have 7. Yeah, I can give them a go. If I can get close enough to a crab. The crab's all the way fucking over there.
Yeah, it looks like you're gonna have to take your time thinning out
the mobs.
The reinforcements, yeah.
I'm gonna run back up to this bonfire. Just in case, and then I am gonna work my way around the... Oh, I'm getting the burps.
Nice.
It's beginning.
You still owe us 2, though, from...
I know, because of my panic.
Yeah. Just reminding you.
I appreciate it.
At home.
Yes, definitely keep up if you wish. I'm going to take another bite, I'm going to drink, and then we shall continue.
And for those of you viewing at home who cannot keep up because you are underage or just do not like drinking... Feel free to do something else equally as embarrassing or intolerable as taking shots.
Yes, like, for every time I die, do a lap around your house in your underpants.
Exactly. Or every time he has to heal himself, make a weird noise. Really confuse your parents and your siblings.
Yes, yes, yes. And make a vine out of it and send it to us, because I want to see that.
Or better yet, not just even make a weird noise, sing out a random song, a different song every time, but sing it like there's just something wrong with you. I came in like a wrecking ball.
Okay, we shall continue.
I'll never have to hurt
enough. Stop it. I can't handle the derp Miley Cyrus right now. I will die.
Doesn't even have to be Miley Cyrus. It can be anyone. Derpy Britney Spears. Hit me, baby, one more time.
You're lucky he died. okay. There's a door over here. Ah! There's a monster, too.
That's one of those snicker monsters.
Oh! I have just enough stamina to kill them with a full combo.
Nice. Dude, we're gonna have so many inside jokes by the time this is over of like what we call different mobs and stuff that by the time you're battling the last boss, if we get any new viewers, they're just not gonna understand the commentary whatsoever.
So this door's locked, but there's a crystal dinosaur and an item back behind it.
Oh yeah, you still... Wait, did you kill the first one of those? I forget.
Yes, it killed me once and the second time it didn't hit me. Oh, crap. Do you see that?
I see. It's really small, though. I can't make out what it is.
It is a black knight from the original Dark Souls, from what it looks like. And they are extremely tough enemies. Okay, so you know how the crystal dinosaur at the very beginning of the game, I called noob bait?
Yeah.
These guys were the original noob bait from Dark Souls 1. There's one in the very first area, and it could literally one-shot you.
Wow.
So
you've got, you can either go attack some new bait, or you can go attack some old new bait.
Yeah, I can't get through that door back there, so this will have to do.
All right, let's
now, if I remember right, these guys are extremely susceptible to backstabs, so let's give that a go.
Buttstab win, friend.
Ow, okay, yep. Broke my guard. And, yes! They do an extreme amount of damage.
Right, but you're not getting one shot, which is great.
You say that, and then I get one shot. Oh, I'm not dead! I wasn't dead, and I put my controller down.
Oh, alright, well, at least it's only one drink and a shot. Or one derpy, you know, insert insert song here.
I want to... Please, somebody, do derpy Maroon 5. That is what I would like to hear right now.
What's a good Maroon 5 song?
I honestly, in my current state, cannot think of a single one of their songs like that's right. by
it'll
name.
Come to me a sec.
But yeah, I'm gonna do a shot and I'll think about it. Oh fuck!
Because recently Adam Levine's been doing stuff on his own, so I can't.
That went down the wrong pipe.
Oh no!
I'm dying. IRL. Okay, and a drink.
What's the new song? I know it. Is it Sugar? Sugar, Sugar by Maroon 5. I just need to be deep in your love. So deep in your love. Sugar, yes, please. Won't you come and put a smile on me? Right here.
Titch, I love
right
you.
Now. Won't you come and put it down on me? Yeah.
You make this better.
That's what I'm here from, buddy.
I have one solitary tear streaming down my face currently from laughing.